It's a volunteer doctor for One Relief charity tells CNN that he witnessed horrific crimes against Syrian civilians. A warning now, viewers, some of these images are graphic and you may find them disturbing. We feel, though, compelled to share them with you in order to show some of the brutal tactics used in Syria's civil war. Again, this report not suitable for everyone. Here's Atika Schubert.
It is a chilling image of just how horrific the Syrian civil war has become. A sniper's bullet in the skull of an unborn fetus. The pregnant mother was the victim of a sniper attack. British surgeon Dr. David Knott volunteered at several hospitals in northern Syria with the charity Syria Relief.
You actually see the bullet hole here going from one side of the uterus to the other side, and the baby was caught in the middle.
These images are graphic, but they are all survivors. Dr. Knott says 90% of the surgeries he performed on any given day were sniper wounds, up to 20 gunshot wounds a day. Syria Relief provided CNN with these pictures of sniper victims in order to raise awareness of the growing violence. Dr. Knott says he believes snipers are specifically targeting pregnant women and sometimes children in a vicious game of war.
For one day, we received, say, 15, 16 gunshot wounds, and of that, 8 to 9 were targeted in the left groin only. And then the following day, they were targeted in the right groin only. I think definitely there was a game going on.
A targeting game.
In this video from Aleppo, men, women, and children try to outrun snipers' bullets as they cross from the regime-controlled enclave of the city to the rebel-held areas. It's not clear who is pulling the trigger in this video, but innocent civilians are literally being caught in the crossfire. They risk their lives because food and provision are on the rebel side, but their homes and families are on the regime side. Desperate, they make a dash for supplies, but not everyone makes it through. It is a scene reminiscent of another conflict, Bosnia. But at that time, the UN operated humanitarian corridors to ensure a steady supply of food and medical aid despite the fighting. Dr. Knott was there.
And it was wonderful to see the lorries coming in, with white lorries with UNHCR written on them, which you knew they were full of provisions and food and medical aid for the besieged town, because that was in an area of conflict with various different factions and so on working. But at least they got their act together on that time.
Yeah.
And I would like that to happen again for Syria.
Do you think it can?
Yes, I do.
Without that humanitarian corridor in Syria, he and other doctors warn these horrific images will not go away. Atika Schubert, CNN, London.